Einstein might be wrong. All hell broke loose in the physics community. It means that time travel could become commonplace, because as you approach the speed of light, time slows down.
In this enlightening discussion, astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson delves into the fascinating concept of faster-than-light interstellar travel. Drawing from his extensive expertise, Tyson unravels the theoretical possibilities, potential challenges, and mind-bending implications of achieving velocities beyond the cosmic speed limit. In this episode, we'll dive deep into the world of speculative physics and the vast expanse of cosmic exploration as we embark on an adventure through the frontiers of interstellar travel. This is Reveal the Mystery. If you are curious to learn mysteries of the world, space, and beyond, consider subscribing. Regrettably, the expanse of interstellar space poses a significant challenge for us. Our current technology is inadequate for venturing to the stars, and to compound this issue, it requires a staggering 4.2 years for light, the fastest entity in the universe, to reach our eyes from the Alpha Centauri system, our closest celestial neighbor to the Sun. According to Einstein's theory of special relativity, nothing can surpass the speed of light. But what if there existed a means to circumvent this cosmic speed limit? What if it were possible to manipulate the very fabric of space-time, enabling us to traverse interstellar distances more swiftly? To the best of our knowledge, nothing can outpace the speed of light in a vacuum. It's not for lack of desire or effort, as we have tirelessly scoured the universe in search of phenomena that might defy this principle. Regrettably, we have not uncovered anything that breaches this rule. Moreover, it is a fundamental principle of Einstein's theory of relativity, suggesting that the speed of light isn't a limitation of our technology, but an inherent characteristic of the cosmos. However, there are alternative methods to achieve faster-than-light travel. In a somewhat unorthodox sense, one could cheat the system, as exemplified in the popular show Star Trek with its warp drives. In this scenario, a spacecraft employs warp drives to bend the space-time continuum, creating a shortcut through the fabric of space-time and drastically reducing the time needed to traverse vast distances. While this concept is entertaining in science fiction, it aligns with the notion that space and time can be curved, and if we could manipulate this curvature, we might achieve significantly faster travel compared to the pace of light. Yet, there is another term for this phenomenon, a wormhole. A wormhole represents a portal in the space-time continuum that allows instantaneous travel from one part of the universe to another. The more energy one can wield, the more extensive sections of the universe can be curved to facilitate such journeys. I propose that if we ever hope to explore the stars, cross the galaxy, or venture to other galaxies, we will need to rely on wormholes and the manipulation of space-time curvature. This appears to be the only feasible way, as even our speediest spacecraft would require 50,000 years to reach the nearest star to the Sun, which is a mere stone's throw in cosmic terms. In April of 1970, the crew of NASA's Apollo 13 mission orbited around the far side of the Moon, placing them at a distance of more than 400,000 kilometers from Earth. This marked the farthest our species has ever ventured from our home planet. To put this achievement in perspective, if we ever aspire to send humans to Mars, we would need to exceed that distance 136 times over. The minimum gap between Mars and Earth measures about 54.6 million kilometers, roughly a third of the distance from Earth to the Sun, which we refer to as one astronomical unit, 1 AU. For context, Neptune, the most distant planet in our solar system, sits approximately 4.5 billion kilometers away from the Sun, equivalent to 30 AUS. Sunlight takes 4 hours to traverse this vast expanse from the Sun to Neptune. While these distances may seem astounding to us, they become dwarfed when we contemplate the Alpha Centauri star system, located a staggering 269,000 AUs away. When discussing interstellar distances, we often rely on light years as a more suitable unit of measurement. As the term suggests, one light year represents the distance that light covers in a single year. In 2025, the Parker Solar Probe is expected to attain a maximum velocity of approximately 690,000 kilometers per hour, making it the fastest human-made object. However, even at such remarkable speeds, it would take more than 6,600 years for an uncrewed spacecraft to reach the Alpha Centauri system. The prospect of sending humans on such a journey is a formidable challenge. Nevertheless, scientists have contemplated a concept and spacecraft design for such endeavors, aptly named Generation Ships. Generation ships are envisioned as vessels where astronauts accept the reality that they may not live to see their destination. They would need to be capable of procreation and child-rearing, with subsequent generations assuming command of the ship. This generational relay continues, raising intriguing ethical questions. To manage this endeavor, strict control over population size is necessary, along with education and training to maintain essential skills within the crew, including engineers and medical personnel. The concept of generational ships presents a unique dilemma when faced with the vast distances of interstellar space in the absence of technologies like wormholes or warp drives. Let's consider a wild idea: building a generation starship and a space program to send people to the Alpha Centauri system. Even if everything goes perfectly and thousands of years later the ship finally arrives, there's no guarantee that the planets there will be suitable for human life. One of these planets, called Proxima B, is in the habitable zone, but we can't be sure it's good for us space settlers. Imagine the disappointment of the last generation of the starship arriving and finding nothing interesting there. A more realistic plan for traveling between stars involves using solar sails pushed by powerful lasers to go at about 10% of the speed of light. With this technology, it would take roughly 44 years to reach Alpha Centauri. The last hope for faster travel across the galaxy lies in the concept of warp drives. However, even if they are theoretically possible, developing them is a long way off. Right now, we are only scratching the surface of space exploration. When people talk about going into space, they often mean going into orbit around Earth, not traveling to other star systems. Only a handful of missions have taken humans to destinations beyond Earth, like the Moon. Most astronauts stay in low Earth orbit, which is where the International Space Station is located, about a couple of hundred miles up. Space isn't merely the enormous cosmos beyond our planet. Concepts like warp drives and wormholes, which have intrigued science fiction for years, offer the promise of superfast space travel. While they may be theoretically feasible, we're grappling with the intricate science and enormous energy demands necessary to turn them into a reality. Scientists hold the aspiration that someday these ideas could pave the way for us to venture beyond our galaxy and explore the universe further.